Hey everyone, what is going on? So I know I said I probably wouldn't have a video out until Sunday, but we're actually not leaving for Florida until tomorrow, so I was able to get a video out today. Didn't think I'd be able to because I thought we would have like a lot of packing to do and whatnot, but no, we actually do get a video out today, and yeah, I'm basically going over the best Pokemon to lead with, or the ones that I think happen to be the best leads when it comes to the Twilight Cup. So I'm basically using Skunk Tank and Alolan Muk in this video as leads, but there's also Drapion, which is a good lead. All those are only weak to ground, so the amount of weaknesses it has is basically a good lead. So if it has very little weaknesses, that's generally a good lead, like these Pokemon that are only weak to ground. So your opponent has to start with a Pokemon that has ground moves basically to have any super effective damage against it, like Toxicroak. But Toxicroak really isn't a good lead because it is a frail Pokemon. So, you know, and plus you don't want to waste Toxicroak in the beginning just in case they don't lead with that. You know, Quillfish is another good lead as well. Unfortunately, I do not have a Quillfish. I do have a Quillfish, but not invested. Trying to save up my Stardust for next month's cup, you know, and all of that, so, and my TMs as well, so that's why I didn't use Quillfish, but Quillfish is a really good Pokemon. Anyway, we do go ahead and take game one. You know, I hope you enjoyed that game. So really good game, really good game. I enjoyed that one. Next Pokemon, or next battle, I am beginning, I believe, with Skunk Tank, no, Alolan Muk this time, and he begins with Quillfish. As I said, it's a really good lead. Now we do a Poison Jab on this Alolan Muk, charges those moves quite nicely. We do go ahead, get off that Dark Pulse, and if you guys haven't noticed, I did basically get better at making the three rings around, you know, when you do the charge moves, making the three rings. You know, I'm not perfect. I still get two rings occasionally, but for the most part, I did get better at making those three rings like that. So we do go ahead, get Dark Pulse off on that Venomoth. Now Venomoth not really doing a lot to Alolan Muk. His does have Bug Buzz. Yeah, his does have Bug Buzz, and that would have obviously knocked me out, so I did go ahead and block that, getting that Dark Pulse off, which we do go ahead and knock out Venomoth. He does bring in his Alolan Ninetales, knocks out my Alolan Muk, that's okay. And of course I'm not going to bring in the Crobat because I am weak to, I actually do bring in the Crobat, never mind. I guess, I don't know why I decided to bring in the Crobat, I guess because I wanted to do damage on it before I could get my Azumel in, and I knew, you know, Alolan Ninetales couldn't compete with Azumarill, especially when Alolan Ninetales is very weak. So that's why I brought in the Crobat, because that was his last Pokemon, so I didn't really have to worry about it. You know, I knew Crobat would get knocked out, but I knew Azumarill would be able to handle the job just fine. And I'd rather have Azumarill as my last Pokemon. That was my thought process starting that battle. But anyway, we do go ahead and take the win with Azumarill. So really cool Pokemon, really powerful Pokemon for the Twilight Cup, so I really did enjoy using it. Jumping into the next battle, I do begin with my Skunk Tank. As I said, it's only weak to ground, so it is a good Pokemon to lead with. He begins with his Houndoom. Now, of course, I don't want to switch because I never like switching first, and you guys probably don't like switching first. He does go ahead and block that Sludge Bomb, would have knocked it out, so I guess that's why he decides to block it. I do go ahead and block that Foul Play because I knew that I would be able to get another Sludge Bomb, which would either force his last shield or knock him out, and I figured he wouldn't use his last shield just because his Houndoom was almost knocked out anyway. He brings in his own Skunk Tank, knocks me out, and I bring in my Toxicroak, which of course has that Mud Bomb, so it is strong. I do go ahead and block that Flamethrower because that would have done a lot of damage to my Pokemon. I do go ahead, get off that Mud Bomb. He's going to go ahead and block it because that would have knocked out his Skunk Tank. And now both of us are down shield, so he does get off his Sludge Bomb. That does a lot of damage to me, and you know, I resist that. So Toxicroak, not really the bulkiest Pokemon, as I've mentioned before, but it's still really good. We do go ahead, get out that Dynamic Punch. Alolan Ninetales is almost knocked out. And we bring in Venomoth. This Psyshock is going to really do some damage to us, but because he's almost knocked out, we're able to take the win with Confusion. So, you know, if he got off one more charge move, of course he would have taken the game, but we do go ahead and pick up the win over there. So, really nice game, really close game as well. We bring in Skunk Tank again, only weak to ground. Now, he starts with Toxicroak, I guess just because he realized that I was only beginning with Alolan Muk and Skunk Tank, but I do go ahead and pull the switch, and he pulls the switch as well. So, that's what I'm basically saying. You don't really want to pull the switch first because, as you know, I'm stuck with Crobat now, and he has Alolan Ninetales, so I either have to burn my shields or let Crobat go down. But we do go ahead and get off that Sludge Bomb, and he's going to go ahead and protect himself, and he gets off his Psyshock, so my Crobat does go down, unfortunately. But I'm able to bring in another Pokemon, so I decide to bring in my Skunk Tank, which the Poison Jab almost finishes finishes it off. He does go ahead and use Psyshock. Now, I figured it was Psyshock because I knew he had Psyshock, and I knew he didn't have a second move, so I knew it was Psyshock. That's why I did that, but, you know, if it was, like, Ice Beam or something else, it could have done a lot of damage, I guess, so. But I decided not to block because I knew it was just Psyshock, which wouldn't have done a lot of damage to Skunk Tank. Now, he does bring in his Houndoom for his last Pokemon. Get off that Sludge Bomb, doing a lot of damage to Houndoom, so he knocks out my Skunk Tank, but we bring in the last Pokemon, Azumel, so despite the disadvantage in the beginning, we actually do go ahead and pick up the win for that. So another really nice game, so I really enjoyed that game. Thanks for the battles, and we're moving on, beginning with Skunk Tank, another awesome lead. He begins with Quillfish, which is, as you guys know, a really powerful lead. So, you know, I did change my Skunk Tank from Bite to Poison Jab just because Bite does not charge up moves fast at all. It takes like forever to charge up moves. Bite is still a good move because of how fast you could use it and whatnot, but I'd rather just be able to charge up my moves with Poison Jab a lot quicker, my charge moves, you know. So we do go ahead, get off that Sludge Bomb. He does block because that would have done a lot of damage to Alolan Ninetales, considering Alolan Ninetales is weak to it. I go ahead, bring in my Azumel. Alolan Ninetales is not going to be able to do much to Azumel, so that's why I enjoy using it. Psyshock is not going to do much. Ice Beam is certainly not going to do much. He doesn't have Ice Beam anymore. He used to, but he switched it for Psyshock. You know, but, yeah, so he gets off his move. I decided not to block because I knew Psyshock was not going to be doing a lot, and we're able to finish off that Alolan Ninetales with Bubble. So we have both charge moves ready to go, activating Play Rough, and that would have done a lot of damage, if not knocked it out. Probably not knocked it out, but probably would have come close. But he does go ahead, get off his move, which is Foul Play, and I go ahead and block that because I wanted to get off my Play Rough, and this is definitely going to take out that Houndoom, so we do pick up another win over there. So, really cool game, really cool game. And we actually do go ahead and pick up that Sinnoh Stone. So, awesome for Community Day. I'm pretty good when it comes to Sinnoh Stones. I have like 23, I think. So, I don't need Sinnoh Stones. I've been saving them up. But I have all the evolutions, plus I have all those saved up. So, I'm good when it comes to Sinnoh Stones. But I know some people might not have Sinnoh Stones. So, if you don't, or if you're low on them, you do get, I believe, a guaranteed 10 on Community Day. So, you can definitely evolve Paliswine anyway. But I'm beginning with my Alolan Mark. He begins with his Skunk Tank. Both of them are really good leads. I go ahead and get off my Dark Pulse, and he's going to go ahead and take that, and that does knock it out because Alolan Muk is a strong Pokemon, and he was really weak. He brings in Houndoom, unfortunately knocking out my Alolan Muk, so I'm in a pretty good position, but, you know, he still has both of his shields. But yeah, he made a switch to Tentacruel, so I'm going to go ahead and make a switch to my Venomoth because I know he can't switch again. That's why I don't like switching first, I like switching second. I've mentioned that multiple times. If, you know, you could, yeah, if you can, you know. I mean, obviously, if you have to switch in the beginning, you have no choice. But if you can help it, you want to wait. So, get off that Silver Wind. He's going to block it. My Azumel comes in. He goes ahead and uses Foul Play. I'm going to go ahead, get off that Play Rough, which he would have knocked out Houndoom, but he does go ahead and block it because this is his last Pokemon. And, yeah, we actually do go ahead and knock out Houndoom with Bubble, so we are able to take the win, so that is yet another win for us, and another Sinnoh Stone. We actually got two Sinnoh Stones for the battles today, and, yeah, pretty rainy day, so pretty disgusting day, I guess, because it's, like, raining, you know. So, yeah, it'll be nice to get into the Florida sun, you know, once we leave tomorrow. But, yeah, I do go ahead, activate Sludge Bomb on Skunk Tank. This is the last battle for this video, and he goes ahead, activates his Ice Beam. I'm going to go ahead and block that because I knew I would get another charge move off, and I did go ahead and use a charge move because I thought he would get his charge move off before I was able to knock him out with Poison Jab, so that's why I decided to go ahead and activate my charge move. He brings in his Toxicroak. I go ahead and switch into Azumel because Toxicroak not really doing much with that Mud Bomb. You know, it's neutral, but Azumel is so bulky, guys. It's a fantastic Pokemon. I can't recommend this Pokemon highly enough. Of course, it loses to Pokemon like Tentacruel, so you have to have other counters. That's why I have Venomoth, but, you know, Toxicroak really not doing much to Azumel. I mean, it did end up doing a lot of damage, but that was over the course of several charge moves, and, you know, so, and plus we didn't block any of them, so that's really nice. We do go ahead and knock out that Tentacruel, but he brings in his Golbat, which I was really unfortunate to see, because he's going to go ahead and block that Ice Beam, and then I'm going to bring in Toxicroak. So if I had the Venomoth, could have went either way. I still think he would have won, because he had his charge move that was super effective, but yeah, that's going to be it for this video, guys. I will see you in the next one. Bye! Thank you so much for watching my latest video. Please like, comment, and subscribe, and don't forget to follow me on Twitter. If you like this video, click on one of the links to check out another one of my videos that you'll probably enjoy.